Hello class, in this lecture we will see what is the first law of thermodynamics. So it is the first law which defining something about the thermal energy. Okay, so the first law of thermodynamics are related to the energy balance. Okay, so we also call it as an energy balance equation or conservation of energy. Okay, so as per the first law of thermodynamics, the statement of first law of thermodynamics is the energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, though it can transfer one form to another. Okay, or we can say the summary of first law of thermodynamics, the total energy of universe is remain constant. Okay, so it won't go anywhere, it remain in the universe. Okay, as per the first law of thermodynamics. So if we talk about the system, okay, then some amount of energy E in is entering to the system and some amount of energy is leaving the system and entering to the surrounding. So it is E out. So when we sum up about the universe, then what we will see, E in plus E out, you will get the energy of universe, which will be remain same. So if it sum up with respect to of universe or with the viewpoint of universe, the everything is here only, nothing get destroyed or nothing get created, it is here as it is here. Okay, so but in case of the system point of view, if we talk, then if we apply a first law of thermodynamics to system to satisfy for universe, then summation of everything entering and the summation of everything living, that will define a first law of thermodynamics. So let's talk about the first law. Suppose this is a system in which E in, energy in, that is entering to the system, and it doesn't mean this is a only one time entering. If adding a multiple time during the process, for example here in the PV plot I supposed to mention a two state, state 1 and the state 2. In between those state our process is performed. For example here state 1 to state 2, we are coming via this path or follow this process, and we are come back to the state 1 by this path or by following this process. Okay, so this is a cycle, it form a cycle. Okay, and here we are talking about a first law of thermodynamics for control mass system of cyclic process. Okay, we are first of all talking about a first law for control mass system. Control mass system, it means it's a closed system whose mass is remains same throughout the process, mass will not be changed. And for cyclic means its system come back to the initial state first, once the it leave the initial state and reaches to final, and again finally it come back to the initial state. So it's cycle, one cycle get formed. So during this process, this transformation, there may be chances of work adding from surrounding to system or system to surrounding. Here may be a chance of means this W and arrow may be both direction, it may be, we can't say it is only work coming from surrounding to system, or we can't say only work going from system to surrounding during this process. It may upward or inward also, but right now I have not shown inward. So just assume it is bidirectional, your work may leave or work may enter during the process into the system. Similarly for Q also, heat also, it may leave or it may enter to the system during this process. Here also it may leave, it may enter. So similarly in the system we are having some amount of E in, some amount of E out. Okay, so here if we talk about the what is the average change in energy of system, if we talk about a rate of change of energy of system, then definitely we will say E in with respect to time minus E out with respect to time, we will get the average change in energy of the system. Okay, so here E in is the rate of energy in, and E out by dt is nothing but the rate of energy out, and dE by dt of system is net rate of change of energy, net rate of change of energy. So net rate of change of energy is there. So if we compare this thing with our account, okay, our saving bank account, so during the month, entire month, okay, only once in account, only once in a month, salary will come in account. And during entire month, multiple time we are making out from the account, we start to withdraw from account. In some people's, there is a multiple money in into the account, or money deposition will be there during the month other than salary. But this may be a chance. So just take a multiple in and multiple out. So in the month, if there is a multiple deposition of money in your account and multiple withdrawal from your account. So if we talk about the what is a change in balance of our account for a month of period, then it may calculate in that way. And suppose if E in goes to zero and just E out, money out is there, and definitely after some time this account will be zero, account balance will be zero, that is system balance will be zero. So if we apply this thing, change in rate of energy, okay, to the any thermodynamic system on the basis of those two assumptions, that is energy interaction only by means of Q and W, means only Q and W in terms of energy interaction is there, and the process is cyclic, then we can say Q amount of heat energy is added into the system, okay, and equal amount of work done, not equal, Q is there and W is removed from the system, okay, then we will get equal amount of heat we are added and equal amount of work we are taking out from the system. So what will left in the system, that is zero, as in case of saving bank account. Okay, we are depositing money, x amount of money, and we stop now x amount of deposition of money, and we are just start to take out those money. So after some span of time, account will be zero. So similarly, Q is added and W amount is withdrawn, we'll getting a zero account. Del Q and del W is, I told you, we are using in D instead of del. We are using del instead of D to represent a small quantity of heat and work, just because it is a path function. Heat and work both are path functions. So instead of dq by minus dw, we are writing as a del q minus del w with a small quantity. And after that, this is cyclic integral of del q minus cyclic integral of del w is equal to zero. Cyclic integral means throughout this process, how many times you have added or you have an interaction in terms of heat during the process, this process, and this process during the transformation of 1 to 2 and 2 to 1 back, how much kind of heat exchange take place, their sum up minus during the process 1 to 2 and 2 to 1, how much kind of work exchange take place, their summation, okay, will give you a zero. And after that, cyclic integral of del q is equal to cyclic integral of del w, because here minus sign is there. So if I take it at right hand side, so I will get del q, cyclic integral of del q is equal to cyclic integral of del w. So this is the energy balance it show for the control mass cyclic process. So that it say it just enter to the system and exactly leave to the system, okay, whatever the energy into the system, that much leaving to the system. So energy not created, not destroyed, it converted one form to another. So in terms of heat, it enter into the system, and in terms of work, it come out from the system, okay, ideally, okay, it's not a real, this law says a ideal phenomena. If the work, whatever the heat is entering, that much amount of work are coming out of the system in energy come into the form of work, okay, so it converting their phase heat to work. So here we have equation, first law of equation for control mass under the cyclic process, that is cyclic integral of del Q equal to cyclic integral of del W. Here the meaning of cycle is nothing but the cyclic process, okay, entire process. So entire the heat interaction during the entire cycle equal to work interaction during the entire cycle. So mean to say this cycle basically consists of two processes. This is the first process, state 1 to 2, and another process 2 to 1. So these two processes make a one cycle. So all the heat energy interaction during 1 to 2 process plus all the heat interaction during 2 to 1 process, their summation equal to all the work interaction during 1 to 2 process and 2 to 1 process, their summation is equal. Means all the heat interaction during cycle equal to all the work interaction during the cycle. So as we told you, the interaction only in terms of heat and work. So we are saying heat in, all the heat in equal to all the heat, mean to say all the heat in equal to all the heat out, or we can say whatever the heat interaction summation, that is it may be in or out, equal to all the work interaction that may be in or out to the system. Okay, so this is your first law of thermodynamics for control mass cyclic process. Thank you.